This is the video for experiment 19, reactions of alcohols and phenols. We'll be looking at the data in the report pages. First up are the questions in the pre-lab review. And the first question is always the same. Are there any specific safety alerts? And in the experiment reading, you'll look for the triangle icons. That's your clue that it's talking about something where there's a safety alert. Disposal directions, in question two, you'll look for the garbage can icons. And the rest of these questions in the pre-lab review are not hard, just based upon your reading of the experiment. In number four, what results are expected with ceric nitrate? Well, you'll be looking for a specific color change, and the text will describe that. In number five, for the Lucas test, you'll be looking for solid formation, or we call it a precipitate. And oftentimes a precipitate is a cloudiness that forms. Question six, again, you'll be looking for color changes, which are indicative of the chemical changes occurring. And 7, 8, and 9, not hard, just based upon the reading. Let's have a look at the data and report sheet. This first section is based upon solubility, solubility in water. And when you test a substance to see if it's soluble, if it is soluble, it becomes uniform. It dissolves. You only see one substance, the water in this case. And if it's insoluble, then you'll see the substance floating on the surface or sinking to the bottom of the test tube. Or you might see a cloudiness develop. In the table, the first blank asks for the unknown number. And remember that we have six or so different versions of the experiments, and so you're welcome to work with a friend on the labs, but always use your own data because your data is associated with your lab number. And you get that lab number when you enter ChemWeb. It'll say student lab number. It's a four-digit number, and you'll enter it there on the first blank. And the rest of these blanks then, you'll be indicating whether or not the substance is soluble or insoluble in water. In part B, the ceric nitrate test, you'll be looking for color changes. A positive ceric nitrate test is when you get a red or an orange color. And on these blanks, then you'll be indicating the color of the sample from the photographs. And over on the left-hand side, you see that we have a variety of alcohols and phenols that are being tested. Some of the alcohols are primary, some are secondary, some tertiary. And then we have a couple of phenols. And then two unknowns. The antiseptic is an unknown, and then you have a legitimate unknown. And you don't know whether it's an alcohol or a phenol, and whether it's primary, secondary, or tertiary, if it is an alcohol. In part C, the Lucas test involves hydrochloric acid, and when it reacts with an alcohol, cloudiness develops. And that cloudiness sometimes will be instantaneous. Sometimes it only appears after a heating of the sample. So in each of these blanks, you'll be using the terms clear or cloudy to indicate whether or not a reaction is taking place. In part D, the reaction with chromic acid, a positive chromic acid test gives a blue-green color. So again, note the colors that are associated with each of those photographs. The iodoform test is looking for a specific kind of alcohol. And a positive test is when you get a yellow precipitate. And let's see, part F, the acidity of phenols. Alcohols are not really acidic. You can mix them with water and still have the same pH that you began with. But if you have a phenol, that OH is acidic and it produces a pH usually near 2 or 3. And when you test pure water, well, you'd expect pure water to be pH 7, but oftentimes it's not because carbon dioxide is abundant in the air. And when carbon dioxide dissolves in water, it forms carbonic acid. So typically pure water has a pH somewhere around 5. And if you do have a phenol, though, that you're testing, the phenol will be a lot lower than that, again, in the range of 2 or 3. Part G is a process that's specific for phenols. They react with ferric chloride to give complexes that are colored. And then finally, in table 19.8, you'll tabulate all this data for your unknown, for the antiseptic, and draw a conclusion for your unknown and for the antiseptic. And I've filled in a couple of blanks here just with theoretical data. Your data may be different. If I got an orange-red color, for example, in the ceric nitrate test, I would say, well, hey, that's a positive reaction for an alcohol. And so I'd put alcohol right here. Under the test for the antiseptic in the Lucas reagent, if it was initially clear, but after heating for 2 minutes turned cloudy, then I'd say, well, hey, that's evidence for a secondary alcohol. So those are examples of how you'll fill that table in. And again, my data is just hypothetical. Then on the next page are a couple summary questions where you'll circle the letter that best describes your unknown using that table that we just talked about. Is your unknown a phenol? Or if it's an alcohol, which alcohol is it? And then number two, use those same descriptors to apply to the antiseptic. And finally, number three, did you get a positive iodoform test? Is this functional group present in your unknown and the antiseptic? A few questions at the end. They're not difficult. They're based upon the chemical tests that you're using in the experiment. And it would be important for you to look at the functional groups that you have in these molecules. Here I've got an alcohol. Here there's an OH, but it's attached to a benzene ring. That makes it a phenol. In number two, got a primary alcohol and a secondary alcohol. 3 and 4. And again, I've labeled these alcohols and phenols as to their characteristics. And then finally, question number 6 is based upon hydrogen bonding. You may want to look in your text, the textbook for the course, where there are some examples of hydrogen bonding, and that will help you with this question. Well, I hope you have fun with the experiment. Remember that you can email or call at any time.